Ice. Ice is actually solid water that forms when water is freezed below the freezing point. And natural ice is actually a mineral, and it grows into hexagonal forms. It has a perfect crystal structure. It has a perfect composition, and when the snowflakes they form, they take the shape of ice crystals. So you can see beautiful ice crystals that are present, and over the time they get what you can call is they get compacted, and as a result of their compaction, they form what we normally call the thick glaciers. And remember, for the glacier, if you have a thick volume of ice, that thick volume of ice should move on its own weight in the action of gravity. तो नॉर्मली ग्लेशियर को अगर आप डिफाइन करना चाहें तो आप ये कह सकते हैं इट इज ए बिग वॉल्यूम ऑफ आइस दैट इज मूविंग डाउन स्लोप बाय द एक्शन ऑफ ग्रेविटी. तो दैट्स हाउ वी नॉर्मली क्लासिफाई ग्लेशियर. वी विल सी व्हाट टाइप ऑफ फीचर्स दे हैव वंस वी गो डीप. So we have a process in which the glacial ice is formed. The first is that we have the flakes of ice that fall, then the snow is buried. Then the snow is buried, and then we have the compression over thousands of years, 10,000 of years, 1,000, 130,000 years. So what happens? The air expels and the ice particles become close and close. You see, these were the particles, then they form close and close, and then they form what we call the glaciers. So I think somebody has accidentally try to close your whiteboard. Okay. So we have few of these processes that you can see in this figure. We have the loose snow, and then we have the granular, and then fine snow, fine grain ice, and coarse grain ice. So remember, जो आप snowfall देखते हैं, that is not glacier. So there is a difference between glacial ice and there is a difference between the snow. So snow is the freshly formed ice, but glacial ice is the one that has been accumulated over thousands of years, and it doesn't have air entrapped and it has a compacted form. तो यहाँ से आपको आइडिया होगा कि जो ग्लेशियर्स हैं वो थाउजेंड्स एंड थाउजेंड्स ऑफ ईयर से प्रेजेंट हैं. ओके, सो इट मींस अगर हम ग्लेशियर्स को ओवरऑल देखें, सो दे हैव वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इंफॉर्मेशन about the past climates and past environments. So they can also tell you the climate, like what was the carbon dioxide levels in the atmosphere at 130,000 years ago or 10,000 years ago. So we can tell the paleoclimate and paleoclimatic conditions and the amount of CO2 by studying the glaciers. So glaciers, as you know, are very important, and they are just like the saviors of Earth. And आपको पता है कि जैसे हम कहते हैं ग्लोबल वार्मिंग से सबसे ज्यादा खतरा जो है वो ग्लेशियर्स को है. तो उससे क्या होगा अगर ग्लेशियर्स मेल्ट कर जाते हैं, तो 2050 तक जो ग्लोबल सी लेवल है वो 50 मीटर्स अप हो जाएगा. अब इसका क्या मीनिंग है? इसका मीनिंग ये है कि ग्लोबल सी लेवल अगर राइज कर जाएगा तो बहुत से कंट्रीज ऐसे जो कोस्टल कंट्रीज हैं, जो आइलैंड कंट्रीज हैं, वो कंट्रीज दे विल बी अंडर वाटर. जस्ट लाइक मालदीव्स जो आपके बिल्कुल नजदीक है, इसके अलावा इंडोनेशिया,
यस सर,
इसके अलावा कैरेबियन आइलैंड्स और बहुत से ऐसे आइलैंड्स जो हैं, दे विल बी अंडर वाटर ओवर द टाइम. सो इट मीन्स ग्लेशियर्स, वी नीड टू प्रिजर्व आवर ग्लेशियर्स. देर हैज बीन फ्यू स्टडीज, इसमें नॉर्वे एंड स्वीडन, because they also have this, they share few of the ice and few of the ice glaciers, the northern hemisphere. So wahan par kafi is hawale se there has been few efforts to preserve these. Okay, so I suggest you guys, if you can please close your okay. So here we have let's see another figure, so it will be more clear to you where we can find the glacial ice. So normally, if you see, this is the North Pole and this is the South Pole. So South Pole mein aap dekhein ki kitna volume hai ice ka, glacial ice ka, and when you move to the equator, it is reduced. And then start increasing. तो आपको पता है कि इक्वेटर कहाँ पर है और साउथ पोल और नॉर्थ पोल कहाँ पर है? Do you know? Okay. So north pole जो है वो तो Arctic Ocean में है and south pole is in Antarctica. So this is the south pole and you see that the whole hill is covered with ice. So it means the glaciers are controlled by the latitudes. Okay, so we have in the south thick ice covering the whole hillock, then at 60 degrees we have less ice, at 30 degree we have even lesser ice, and at equator we have the least. So can you please tell me where we fall? Like Pakistan, कौन सी latitudinal positions में fall करेगा? Are we the North Pole, South Pole, or at equator? किसी को पता है? Anybody knows?
30 degree पे sir. 30 degree पे.
हाँ. So it means के our glaciers or our ice cap will definitely be something like this. Okay. So we are located north of the equator, about 30 degree, as Hamza said. So we have, if you see the thickness, it is like 8 kilometers, or the height at which you expect the glaciers to be present. So it means 4 kilometer above sea level if you are at 60 degree latitude, and about 6 kilometer at 30 degree latitude. It means if you are in Pakistan, if you are above the sea level approximately 6 kilometer, the chances are there that you can find the glacial ice or glaciers. So it is actually there are many terminologies that are involved. So normally the glaciers that are present on the poles, we call them polar glaciers, or these regions are called the polar regions, and these areas where we have the equator, so we call them the equatorial regions, or then the glaciers are called the equatorial glaciers. तो ये जो elevation है इसको हम कहते हैं snow line. तो ये snow line जो है ये बड़ी important है, because this snow line will tell you like okay what type of that area has elevation, and based on that elevation what type of features and what type of glaciers are expected. So it means the message from this slide is that glaciers sustainability is dependent on the location of glaciers, whether they are located at the equator, whether they are located at 30 degree, whether they are located at 60 degree. And similarly, it also will show you like, okay, at what particular height you are expecting the presence of this glacial ice. Okay, so I have a question for you. Anybody knows what is the height of Sargodha above sea level? Anyone? You guys know?
Sir, kya question tha?
Question is the height of Sargodha above sea level. Anybody knows?
Maybe 45, sir.
Come again?
₹190.
Okay, so 190 meters, it means it is less than a kilometer. Okay, so this is what? This is 4 kilometer, this is 2 kilometer, and then this will be 1 kilometer. So approximately Sargodha will be something like, if we consider Pakistan, so we will be like somewhere here. So that's means we have rare chances of finding glacial ice in Sargodha. Similarly, if you compare Mari or if you compare the upper Kalkan, so maybe we already are at this particular height. So remember this rule, you can apply this rule approximately in many areas where you want to study the glaciers. And normally the person who study glaciers, we normally call them glaciologists. So geologists who specialized in glaciers, we call them glaciologists. And you remember the famous guy jis ne theory of continental drift proposed ki thi, you remember his name?
Alfred Wegener.
Yes, Alfred Wegener was also a glaciologist. So he was studying glaciers. Then unfortunately, during his one of his field trip, he lost his life. So during one of his field, Greenland ke andar ye field work kar raha tha, aur zyada climate aur iski kuch he was not having good health at that point, and due to extensive work, he lost his life in one of the glaciers in Greenland. So it means glaciers are very important, and we need to study them. And as I was saying, many countries like Norway, Sweden, Finland, what they are doing, they are trying to preserve the glaciers. They are trying to remove the... So what these countries are doing, they are trying to maintain their glacial volume so that in order to... So in the process that they can preserve the glaciers and prevent the global sea level from rising, and as a result to control the CO2 emissions in the atmosphere to prevent the rise in temperature. Okay. So let's see a few of the terminologies. So we have the glaciers. Normally what they do, you see, under the action of gravity, they want to travel from the highest mountainous areas to the lowest mountainous areas or the plain areas. So in order to do that, they create a interesting class of features. Some of them are depositional features and some of them are erosional features. So as a result of movement down the slope from high mountainous areas, as we have seen in the last figure, that more chances are there, especially if you are talking about Pakistan, that you will find the glaciers at heighted areas or at the mountainous areas. So in order to see if these glaciers are moving towards the plains, and in order to know that these glaciers will move to the low elevation areas, and then as a result of that, these glaciers will form important erosional as well as depositional features. So the tall mountain peaks, as you have seen, Nanga Parbat and K2, most of the time or most of the year, they will be covered with ice, and that ice is like the glacial ice. And then we have some of the silt glaciers that are just like a glacial that is enclosed and cannot move, and is enclosed from all sides. So it is like a small body of glacial ice that is entrapped. And then we have the valley glacier, a glacial that is moving along a valley, and then it is moving to a less height area from a more mountainous place. Similarly, if a cap is covered with ice, so we call them the ice cap, and we have the peat mount glaciers, we have the silt glaciers, and we have the valley glaciers. So these are broadly few of the types of glaciers that are that we can have. And in that, we have the glaciers that can be present along the axis of a valley. So we call them the valley glaciers. So Himalayas mein jo aapke glaciers hain, jisme ek famous glacier hai, jisko kehte hain Baltura glacier. So Baltura glacier ko agar aap dekhen, to it is most like the valley glacier. So it is present near the K2. So you can also search on the internet and see a few of its beautiful images. And then we have the mountain ice cap, so K2, and the examples from the Nanga Parbat are good examples of the mountain ice cap. And then we have the peat mount glaciers. So peat mount glaciers is a type of glacier. Jab glacier ek closed valley se open place ke upar jata hai, ek aise area mein jo zyada प्लेन एरिया हो और माउंटेनस एरिया ना हो, तो ऐसे ग्लेशियर्स को हम कहते हैं पीट माउंट ग्लेशियर्स. सो ग्लेशियर्स को आप ऐसे ही समझ लें जैसे अभी आई थिंक इन द कमिंग स्लाइड्स वी विल हैव सम ऑफ द एग्जांपल्स. सो यू कैन सी इट वेरी वेल. यस, सो दिस इज द एग्जांपल फ्रॉम द हिमालयस, एंड this is the example, beautiful example of valley glacier. So you see that these mountains are on the sides, and then both sides are covered with the mountains, and even the mountains are covered with ice. And then you see the valley is lined with the glacier, and you see the whole area is almost covered with the ice. So you have listened about the name of Siachen. Siachen ka naam aapne suna hoga kafi dafa. So Siachen is actually a glacier jiske upar there has been few wars between India and Pakistan that has been on these glaciers, and actually it is very hard to survive in these conditions because of the temperature and because of the conditions. So you can broadly call these valley glaciers as rivers. So आप इनको rivers भी कह सकते हैं कि ये आपकी जो valley है, जैसे आप देखें कि एक glacier यहाँ से smaller glacier है, valley glacier, वो इस glacier में आके यहाँ पे शामिल हो रहा है, तो वो हो सकता है यहाँ से कोई और smaller glaciers थे, वो उसके अंदर शामिल हो गए, and then that glacier is moving. लेकिन इसमें आपने एक चीज जरूर याद रखनी है कि जो glacier की speed होती है, वो स्पीड जो है कम होगी एक रिवर की स्पीड से. ग्लेशियर्स जो हैं वो बहुत कम उनकी वेलोसिटी होती है, बिकॉज दे हैव अ वेरी लार्ज वॉल्यूम ऑफ आइस, सो दे मूव बट मूव वेरी स्लोली. तो वाटर जो है वो तो आपको पता है कि उसकी जो स्पीड होती है वो ज्यादा होती है एज कम्पेयर टू द ग्लेशियर्स. So here is another example, beautiful image of a peat mount glacier, and you see that these are the hills, and so these were the hills, and there was an opening, and in that opening the glacier volume has been moving from that particular place in the valley. So is tarah ka jo glacier jo plain area mein aa jaye from the mountains, and it have a fan shape, तो इसकी जो shape है मोर लाइक ए फैन. आपने देखा होगा कि वो जो चाइनीज फैन होते हैं जो नॉर्मली पेपर से बनाते हैं, तो उसी की शेप इसकी शेप है. दैट्स व्हाई वी कॉल देम द पीटमोंट ग्लेशियर्स एंड इट हैज अ वेरी पर्टिकुलर शेप ऑफ ए फैन. और जिस तरह अलूवियल फैंस हम देखेंगे आने वाली स्लाइड्स में, स्पेशली जब हम पढ़ेंगे वाटर इरोशन, तो आप देखेंगे कि उसमें अलूवियल फैंस भी होते हैं. जब एक रॉक वॉल्यूम इसी फॉर्म में नीचे की तरफ डाउन द स्लोप मूव कर दे, उसको हम अलूवियल फैन कहते हैं. सो पीटमोंट ग्लेशियर, तो टुडे क्लास इज मोर लाइक एन इंट्रोडक्टरी अबाउट दी glaciers and how they normally look like, to sharing some of the photographs. So we have the glacial ice. So normally jo glacial ice hoti hai usme two types ke behaviors hote hain. Ek behavior hota hai jisko hum kehte hain brittle, aur ek behavior hota hai jisko hum kehte hain plastic. So brittle behavior jo hai wo normally aapki jo upper ek layer hai uske andar aapko brittle behavior nazar aayega, जबकि जो लोअर आपके वो लेयर है जो रॉक तक जाती है, जो लोअर पार्ट है, उसमें नॉर्मली यू विल हैव दी प्लास्टिक और डक्टाइल फ्लो. सो इट मींस दी अपर पार्ट ऑफ ग्लेशियल इज मोर सब्जेक्टेड टू एंड कैन हैव क्रैकिंग, जिसको आप क्रीवेसिस कहते हैं. और नॉर्मली आपने देखा होगा कि बहुत सी जो माउंटेन एरियाज में मूवीज बनाई जाती हैं या जो एक्सपीडिशंस होते हैं माउंटेन एरियाज में, उसमें मोस्टली जो माउंटेनियर्स होते हैं दे फॉल इन दीज क्रीवेसेस. तो वो इस तरह के जो क्रीवेसेस होते हैं उससे वो उनकी डेथ हो जाती है या दे आर इंट्रैप्ड एंड देन लेटर दे आर गोइंग टू बी रिकवर्ड. इसी तरह जो लोअर पार्ट है इट विल हैव मोर डक्टाइल फ्लो. और रिमेम्बर कि ये जो लोअर पार्ट है ना, इट विल पिक दी रॉक्स जो आपके सब सरफेस के यहाँ पे सरफेस की जो रॉक्स प्रेजेंट हैं सेडिमेंट्स की फॉर्म में, या आप ये कह सकते हैं कि इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रॉक सरफेस, तो यहाँ से वो मटेरियल को ये पिक करेगी ग्लेशियल आइस एंड देन इट विल मूव इट टू ए न्यू लोकेशन. तो नॉर्मली व्हेन न्यू आइस, जब इसके ऊपर एक नया स्नोफॉल का एपिसोड होगा, तो चांसेस आर देयर दैट न्यू आइस विल फिल दीज गैप्स एंड हील दीज क्रीवेसेस. बट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट समटाइम इट इज जस्ट लाइक द कवर एंड इन बीनीथ यू विल फाइंड ए डीप फ्रैक्चर और डीप क्रीवेस. सो चांसेस आर देयर दैट सम ऑफ दीज glaciers they can cause or pose you a problem. So that's why